Hello and welcome to another Bedroom Guru. Firstly, I want to say thank you so much for all the wonderful messages and emails that I get from you concerning the videos and how much help they're bringing. And that's what I've always ever aimed for. So I'm so happy to be doing these and helping people. We've been up in the heavens for the last couple of videos, haven't we? So I thought I'd bring it back down and address a couple of emails that have turned up about how people can, you know, cope with life. And the reason I was inspired to do this video today is for things that happened yesterday, which I'll go into in a moment, about cosmic ordering, positive living and laws of attraction. Now, I don't want to harp on too much about my dark days, the dark night of my soul, during my transition, which was obviously when I had my road accident and has left me mainly bedbound and housebound. Don't get me wrong, the old me used to be very impatient and a bit of a drama queen. Some people will say a lot of a drama queen. During my first couple of years of my road accident, when I was really, really badly ill, any single thing, whether it be a bill come through or, you know, a pipe gone on a radiator, would send me into an absolute frenzy, because my energy was literally, if you put it like as a barrel, it was full up. It was absolutely full up with so much angst, so much hurt, so much self-pity, so much depression. I just couldn't take one more thing, and I literally used to absolutely lose the plot. I couldn't handle anything. On top of that, I'd lost my faith. I disconnected from those beautiful energies up above, because I just thought they're a load of rubbish, they don't exist, I hate the world, I hate me, I want to die, I've had enough. I was in the worst possible mental, spiritual and physical place you could possibly imagine. And I think part of my path is obviously share this with you. Some of you, you know, won't have a life-changing thing that's happened. However, you know, we all get things, you know, the pain in the bottom, X, problems at work, problems with money, problems with health, problems with friends. We all come across various obstacles in our life and challenges in our life, but there is a way to make it better. There is a way to ride the storm and embrace the rainbow afterwards. I love that. You get quite a lot of that on Twitter, don't you, and Instagram? Ride the waves. And you think, yeah, whatever, I just want to go under and stay there and be cold and wet and never breathe again. You know, so I totally get it. I totally get it, that you just want to give up. So what happened was, is that I remember when I first started to be shown that the spirit world were there and that I needed to kick myself up the bum. And one of the things that I was introduced to during a dream state was cosmic ordering, creating the life that I wanted, creating the abundance around me without any pressure, and being able to deal with any obstacles or any problems that came into my life with serenity and almost laughing at it, because it was just so ridiculous, you know. At that point, I'd lost most of my friends that I thought were my friends back then, but it was the best thing that ever happened. Because really what was happening was, during my transition, during my dark night of the soul, and if you don't know what I'm talking about, dark night of the soul, rather than waste video time, if you Google that, then you'll understand it. Lots of people have gone through the transition since 12/12/12, where your world has been turned upside down, and then you're plonked back down in a completely different life, a completely different mental attitude, completely different purpose, and you think, what the hell just happened there? And it was all meant to be, because it basically puts you in place for whatever your spiritual path is for 2018. We are in dire straits, in a world full of war, hate, greed, tyranny. I can't stand watching the news anymore, because it just completely obliterates my positive bubble that I have. And so this is part of why I do these, because I need to spread education, love, humanity, and how we can cope on a daily basis. So yes, cosmic ordering. I thought, well, a load of old pants, you know, what is that, like a magic fairy turns up and gives you what you want? It's a load of crap. That's what mind state I was in. However, I thought I'd give it a little go, and I had a couple of weeks where I felt quite well, and so I said, right, well, if this is real, So I said, I want you to send me some gold, not just any old rubbish. I would like some gold just to try this out. Okay. I think they did it to me because I basically, I don't think it was for the greater good. I think they just needed to prove to me that it worked so then I could start working it, because I was in a dire place of complete skepticism, you know. And I said, and also I then pictured a new car, because I needed a new car because I'd had an accident and I knew I couldn't afford one. I knew that I couldn't afford a new car, but I couldn't stand being in a low car. I couldn't stand being in a level that everybody else was driving at. And so I thought, well, I can't afford one of these SUV or high, you know, high base cars. So I don't know how that's going to work out, but crack on then. And so that's what I did. It was like totally, it was such a rude and arrogant way of asking them to prove it. I can't believe they did it. So anyway, what happened was, is that I had put on weight because obviously I'd been stuck in bed and couldn't exercise, and basically I went to Tesco's and I bought a pair of jeans, took them back and took them back home, tried them on too tight. Why can't they ever be too big? Wouldn't it be a great one to make you feel good? Anyway, so I took them back and this was about 3 days after I'd said about bring me gold, right? Because I thought there's no way they're going to be able to do that. So the lady said, we've got none of those jeans left. She goes, however, you know, you've got some money here. If you want to go and have a look around, see what you, you know, see what you want to have a look at. So I found these pair of trousers. I thought, I'll have them. And a couple of other bits, went back home. Put the trousers on and I thought that there was a tag stuck in the pocket. And so I was trying, because it was digging in. And I took it out and I could not believe what I was looking at. It was a gold bangle. It was a gold bangle, right? Brand new pair of trousers. And I thought, oh my good God. And I thought, well, should I take it back to there? You know, how is it in there? I just couldn't understand how it was in there. And it just, I just was so amazed because I'd asked for this gold to come to me. And I thought, I'm going to need to take it back. And then I thought, well, no, because I've asked for it. It's been delivered to me in the most unbelievable way. So I did keep it. Well, it was really bad. I didn't know what to do, and I didn't know how they would trace it, to be honest with you. You know, who came in? I don't know if someone tried the trousers on, put them back on the rack, but they were brand new and their bangle had come off. I just don't know. But I did phone up Tesco's and pretend that I'd lost the bangle and said, has anybody reported it? And I did that for a couple of weeks after, and nobody had. So that kind of allayed any karmic route that would happen for me keeping this bangle. So I thanked them. I thought, this is a bit weird. And then I was driving, I then had to go to Sainsbury's, it was in Rayleigh, on Rayleigh Weir in Essex, and I wasn't great at driving. I was worse in the passenger seat, because that's how the accident happened. And I just forced myself, because I'd run out of mincemeat. I wanted to make a spaghetti bolognese. It was quite a good day then. So I thought, I can do this. It was only 5 minutes from my house. And so I drove past Ford's, because that's on the way into Sainsbury's, and I looked at this car and thought, I love that car. And I went in there and I know the bloke's in there, and I said to them, that car there, I said, and it was so it was ridiculous. I think it was about £22,000. There was no way on earth I could buy it. There was no way at all. And I said, what's that doing now? It's only like a few months old. And he goes, oh, don't. He said, one of the managers ordered it, but it was over his bracket, what you could order or something. He said, so we've got to put it straight on the, there they go. So he always start barking, didn't they, as soon as I start talking. And he said, we need to put it back on the forecourt. So I was like, right, okay. And he goes, and so there's a massive discount on it, so we've got to take the discount off of the brand new price. I went, okay. And so he said, and plus you've got your car. And he goes, I can put that in. And he goes, and then we can have a little deal because you're a loyal customer and take some more money off. In the end, right, I drove off with that car a couple of days later. It was perfect. It was high up. It's like a Ford Cougar, so it was really sturdy, enough room for the dogs. And I only ended up paying an extra $4,000. Don't even ask me how that worked out. I couldn't believe it. So within a week, I'd had the two things that I'd visualised that I needed for me. And I thought, this is a bit interesting. So I started meditating on it when I was on good days, and they started to show me how to do it. And I think I've mentioned this before in another video, but there's an analogy that one of my guides showed me a couple of weeks ago, and I think it's perfect for this, right? Because I was asking about how can I tell people how to do this, because, you know, and so I'll give you the fundamental rules in a minute. But what I will say is everything, once you start working this, is provided for you. And I'll give you the examples of what happened yesterday to show you what my life's like now. Because trust me, it was never like that before. I'll tell you that now. And the analogy that my guide gave me was, imagine that you get in the back of a taxi and the taxi driver turns around and says, well, where do you want to go? What's your destination? You know, what do you need to do? Where do you need to go? And you just sit there and say nothing. Right, he doesn't know where to drive you, does he? So you're not going to go where you actually want to be. If you say, well, I don't know, it's not worth me getting in this taxi really, because I'm not going to get there, they'll go, all right then, get out. And so I thought, oh my god, this is so clever. And basically what they were trying to give the analogy on was your intentions to the universe, what you send out to the universal energies. We're all on the same consciousness, if you like. There's just different frequencies of it. So for instance, if you send out something like, I'm never going to get that money, I'm never going to make it, I'm never going to get that new job, I'm never going to get over this, all you're doing is sending out a huge massive negative to the universe, and that taxi driver, the universe, is going to say, all right then, stay there then, you know. And I've worked it now for 4 years, and I'm telling you, it does work. So your intentions, even though it's impossible and that you just think, I ain't going to be able to do this, you just say, I'm going to be in that new house next year, I'm going to get that job. And then you sit and visualize yourself actually doing the job. Rather than say, oh, please, can I have that job? You say, thank you for giving me the job that I want. You're affirming. Affirmations are so strong in your life. I always create affirmations. Today will be a good day. Today I'm going to be doing this. Thank you for this day. Thank you for the fact that this is going to be okay. Now I affirm it and confirm it. Affirm and confirm everything that you want to know. Obviously anything you ask for is for the greater good. So I would assume in layman's terms that if you send a thought out of what you need or what you would like or what you want to aspire to, they will obviously check. I suppose like a credit check. They'll go, all right, this, what does the computer say? The computer says no. But they will see if it's for the greater good and if it will complement your human experience on the earth plane. And so basically, they will bring you what you need. It's like times when I haven't had money and then something will pop in and just to cover what I need it for. No more, no less, exactly what I need to cover it for. And that's happened so many times. Sometimes the exact amount I need. And so basically, what you send out and ask for, if it's for the greater good, you know, if it's out of greed or envy or rage or revenge, it's not going to happen. You're sending out a negative vibration that's just going to come straight back on you. And this was definitely something that I recognised, because now around me, I have an abundance of the most beautiful, honest, truthful, helpful, loving friends I could possibly imagine. And before I didn't. And really what you're doing is what you give out, what your thought process gives out, what your energy gives out, the acts of kindness, the acts of love that you give out will come back, because you're creating your reality. And so I basically look at my friends and realize I'm doing good. Look at who's around you. Look at what's happening around you. And if it's bad, it's because you're actually feeling that you deserve that. So you need to change your thought process. You need to change your energy. You need to change your vibration. You need to do an exercise contentment. Now, one of the things that I do during the day is I thank the universe, and I think how lucky I am by simple things. I have things around me I love. You've most probably noticed in my videos that I always have like angels. You can just mostly see the wings of my little angel over there. I create the colour that I want around me. I create the environment I want around me. I create things that make me feel positive. I adore Tinkerbell. Look, I've even got my little Tink top. Yay! And I have Tink pajamas. I've got a Tinkerbell that looks over me and I can see her as soon as I wake up. I've got beautiful floral display out there because I've chosen to have a bedroom that's right by the garden. I'm creating an abundance around me of things that I like to look at. Declutter. If you wake up or you're sitting in your lounge and there's like a load of clutter in the corner that's driving you insane, you're lowering your vibrations and thinking, for God's sake, it's doing my head in. Clear it out. Clear mind, clear space, clear home. It all helps create this abundance and this contentment within you. The more happy you are with yourself, the more stronger your vibration of what you wish to occur will come back and deliver. And I've had so many comments where people go, God, we've had the most amazing day. It's so special. I said, these are my normal days now. If you enter into this and just put a bit of effort into self-love, self-awareness, and creating happiness and contentment around you, you will get this every single day of your life, where whatever comes up, you know, no matter how bad it is, you are going to walk through it and it's going to be fine. And I know that every single day now. So for instance, the inspiration for this video today, as I say, one was because a couple of emails come through of people that are struggling. And how, you know, how do I seem so contented when most of the time I'm in bed? But yesterday I had my beautiful friend Lindsay come and stay. We were in the police together, very young coppers, very naughty. We were good. No, not really. But we had fun and we always got on so well. We were really, really close friends. Life took us down different paths. Obviously, I completely withdrew during my dark night of the soul. And miraculously, a couple of years ago, she came back into my life. And now it's like we've got a soul connection again. And she's even doing my prism living course. And the change in her is unbelievable. Because all of these tools and all of the things I've used to be content and serene in my life are in my prism living online course. And they're really, it's really not hard work to get in this space. It really isn't. So let me give you a for instance of what yesterday was like, just to show you what most of my days are like. I just had a flash of inspiration the night before we went out yesterday that we should go to Cheddar Gorge. And you'll mostly see photographs on my Twitter account or Instagram and on Pinterest because it was just a magnificent day. She'd heard from her husband and apparently it was raining. It was horrendous in Essex. But here I thought, nope, it's going to be a perfect day. And I said, thank you, Archangel Ariel, for creating a beautiful day for us, because I wanted the weather to be lovely. It was red hot in Cheddar Gorge. The sun was vibrant. It was a beautiful, stunning day. And when I just sent out a thought, thank you for a perfect day, before it even started. When we got to Cheddar Gorge, the place was rammed with parking, and I obviously have got limited mobility. And I hadn't bought the wheelchair because I thought, no, this is going to be a perfect day. I don't need to. So we basically, as we went into the middle of the high street, I don't know if you've ever been there, but it's not a lot of parking actually in that bit. This car just pulled straight out in front of us just as we were pulling in. So we had the perfect car parking space just near Goff's Caves. And I thought, right, this is going good. And then we walked out, and I'm obviously gluten and dairy free, it's a nightmare going out and eating. And the first cafe we come to, the Lion's Rock Cafe, it said specialist in gluten and dairy free and vegan. I'm like, oh my God, okay, we're going to eat there. Thank you. And then as we walked up to Goff's Caves, we went to the door, and I was concerned about if I'd make it around it because I hadn't bought my wheelchair. And so I said to her, look, you know, I've got limited mobility. And I said, you know, I haven't got anything to show you, but I'm just concerned if I'm going to make it or not. And so she went, don't worry. She goes, listen, she goes, this is obviously your carer for the day and she'll help you if there's any problems. So we'll let her go in for free. And I said, thank you very much, because obviously I've got to watch my pennies because I'm moving. And I was like, thank you so much, it's very kind. And I said, but I really need to eat something, because when we don't eat ME people, we will end up shaking, trembling and very weak. So she said, go on, just go off, don't worry, it's fine. And if I'm not here, I'll tell someone else that you're coming in with your friend. I'm like, okay. So Lindsay's like, wow, that was good, that was lucky. It's not luck. I've attracted that. I've attracted this beauty and ease around me. And so we go to this cafe. And Lindsay and I have both lost our mums this year, only a few weeks apart. And I said, I reckon our mum's with us today. And the reason I thought that is because I accidentally called Lindsay twice, Lou, and she went, what did you call me that for? And so I said, I don't know, it's really weird. And she goes, you do know that my mum and my dad and only my closest friends who I grew up with called me Lou, and I never knew that. And she said, oh my God, she goes, do you think our mum's with us today? I said, I think they're giving us a really special day. I honestly believe that. I said, there's going to be special things happening today. Again, I thank them. Thank you for the special things to come. So we walked into this cafe and it was just simply beautiful. It was all like shabby chic. It's all set in the 1940s. And we decided to sit out in the garden and it looks up at Lion's Rock, which is just absolutely stunning. Red hot sun. It was beautiful. And I think I've put it on my Facebook. I'm sure I've put it on Twitter as well. Because what happens then is a number one spirit messenger, Robin, turns up and sits a foot away from us. And I said, that's just not a normal Robin. I said, that's a messenger from our mums. And so because Lindsay started opening up to the spiritual understanding, she got a phone straight away. And I basically said, hi, I love you, as you know, to our mums. And that Robin just stared at me. And I said, that he's here for both of us, Lindsay. And then the Robin stared at Lindsay, then stared back at me, then stared back at her. And it just stayed there staring right in our eyes, literally from one to the other. Then it flew off. Then I thought, I'm going to be able to give this food to say thank you for being a spirit messenger. I held a bit of bread and it came up and it basically ate. It was eating. It was hovering like a hummingbird and it was eating from my fingers. It was magical. And then there was these ladies who asked if we could have a picture, if we wanted a picture. And the Robin then just flew from wherever it was and got in the photograph just as she was taking it. I just couldn't believe it. So the Robin is in between us, like standing there, like if it was our mums. And I was like, oh my goodness, this is so incredible. We had a fantastic meal because everything was obviously catering for our dietary needs because Lindsay's gluten-free as well. And it was just perfect. So then we came from there and we walked up to Gough's Caves and that lovely lady was still there. And she said, right, just take your time, don't worry. And if you need to come back or you need us to come and get you, you know, she was brilliant, come and get us. The caves in there are stunning. I recommend if you go to Cheddar Gould, go in those caves. Children will love it. It is the most stunning cave system you'll ever see. And so I was very slowly walking, now and then sitting. I was determined to get round there. And then randomly I kicked something on the floor. I don't know if I'm allowed to do this. I could be end up and get in trouble. And I looked down and it was a black calcite wand. And I knew I had to give it to Lindsay. And so I said, this is for you. And she goes, what the properties? I said, I don't know, but it's not just a normal bit of stone. It's a calcite, it's black calcite. So I thought, you know, it's a gift. Went into another place and then this random person comes up to me and says, this is for you. Right, and they'd found it on the floor. It hadn't been taken from anywhere. It dropped off a stalactite. Or perhaps a stalagmite and rolled down, I don't know. And when I took it, I could feel the vibration of it. And when I looked, it was pure calcite. Now, I know that calcite is absolutely the best stone for people with ME and chronic illness and pain. It just basically is a cleansing stone, very powerful stones. It can cleanse other stones. But a lot of our ailments and the things that we have to cope with, calcite is perfect for. And I was like, why? And they said, I don't know, I've just got to give it to you. And then someone else comes up and gives Lindsay a stone and it's a gold calcite they found, said, you've got to have this. And it was exactly what she needed, deeper meditation, deeper understanding of spiritual mind focus. And there was many other things. And the black calcite was for dealing with grief. And letting go and getting rid of old habits of, you know, thinking of negative things. It was just mind-blowing. Then it turns out that we're the only people in the whole cave system. It was like we had a private tour. Everybody then just disappeared after we got the stones. And we was in this cave system and literally we were the only ones, nobody else. And we ended up in what you'll know as, if you've been there or if you ever go there, the diamond, which is the absolute... Oh my God, it is just the absolute perfect environment where the stalactites, it is just the most stunning, stunning view. And this Petra, who was there, God bless her heart, started talking to us. And because we were the only ones there, and she said, I'm going to do this for you. She said, I'm going to turn off all the lights and you can just sit and reflect on the sounds in there. And it was just like the most deepest, quickest meditation. Because all you could hear were the stalactites dripping, but all the different layers of the cave. It was mind-blowing. She then gave us a show of what it would look like with the sunrise coming up over all these sparkling stalagmites and stalactites. And it was just, oh my goodness, it was so special. Then unfortunately, I started to get some really severe spasms in my back and my buttocks and my legs. And I thought, I'm not going to make it out of here. And then amazingly, these two ladies just turned up who were staff members. And one of them turned out to be this beautiful healer. And she stood with her hand on my back. And she was like a Reiki master. And she said, come on, let's go. We can do this. Because I thought, I'm stuck in bloody caves. I can't walk properly. I'm in agony. And then they started singing songs. She had the most beautiful voice. And we sang songs all the way back to the entrance to give me that mindset, to give me that impetus to carry on and get out of the caves. I then sat down on the stairs and she sat by me and chatted with me while Lindsay went to get the car. Earlier on in the day, I absolutely adore dragonflies. Dragonflies represent a reminder that we should not be fooled or should be embraced in the falseness of humankind and the world. The illusion of, you know, the world down here in the material world, it invites you to look past that to transformation and spiritual acknowledgement and spiritual abundance. And I'd walk past and I'd talk out loud, because I'm on my own, I'd talk out loud all the time about my thoughts. I thought, oh, I could just have that dragonfly. And it was a handmade wrought iron one-off dragonfly that you like stick in the ground in the garden. And I thought, you know what, I really, really want to treat myself to that as a new present. And I thought, no, I can't. I've got to watch my pennies because I'm moving. I've got to watch every single penny. And anyway, we carried on walking. Lindsay turns up and she says to me, I've got a present for you. And I did create a drama actually in the middle of Cheddar Gorge because she bought me the dragonfly. Couldn't believe it. She just bought me a dragonfly. I actually burst into tears with happiness. And the manager was like, oh my God, from Goffs goes, you're right, you're right. Because they thought I was like, just had enough of the pain. And I was like, no, I said, this is just the most beautiful, fantastic day. And she said, I can't believe everything that's happened today. It's just been so weird. I said, it's not weird. I said, this is spiritual living. This is positive living. This is prism living. This is how your days go. This is how it works. All you've got to do is embrace it and send out what you would like. Send out your intentions. Focus on where you want to be, who you want to be, who you want to be surrounded by. It works. You've just got to find yourself in this most quiet space and you just have to sit there and embrace the energies around you and then clearly send out your intentions. Think about what you're going to ask for, because be careful, because what you do ask for, you will get. If it's anything to do with negativeness against anybody else, or you want karma, or you want revenge, it's not going to work. All you're going to do is sit in your own vengeful energy. You don't want to be doing that. You want to be sitting in this light energy. Thank you for bringing me the abundance. Thank you for bringing friends around me that respect me and love me and are honest with me. Thank you for all the opportunities that are coming my way. You know, and that's how you do it. So we ended up coming back and we had a lovely evening. And then last night, and this just shows how the obstacles work. Last night, I was just, thank you so much for the most perfect day with my beautiful friend. And we had such a beautiful day because we knew our mums were with us. And I was just about dropping off to sleep. And then somebody said, oh, check your bank account. I'm like, God. So I did. And by mistake, because I've been in a relapse, sometimes I can't handle looking through my emails and my home insurance had come up. And by mistake, they'd taken the whole amount for the year. And I was like, oh my God, I just haven't got the money to do that. What the hell? Now, the old me would have gone ragey, stupid bloody people. Rah, 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 rah. How am I going to afford this? That's just bloody great. It's over 300 quid. Da, 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 da. And I would have set myself in this motion of rage. Remember, thought creates emotion, creates behaviour. And I would have had a really crappy night of not being able to sleep. So I thought, that's all right, I'll deal with that tomorrow. So Lindsay came in, bless her, making my breakfast, such a star. Came in, sat down with me, and I went, I've got a problem. I said, I'm watching every penny, and they've just taken over, £300 out. £318. I said, that's not good. So I said, but you know what, it's going to be all right. She went, okay. So I phoned them up, explained my situation, that I hadn't read the email because I was in a relapse, didn't realise they were going to take the whole amount out. She said, that's absolutely fine. And it's really weird because her name was Jill, and it was Julianus who'd woke me up the night before, and the other woman that helped me was Julie. Could be coincidence, but it's very close to Julianus. And cut a very long story short, I was completely calm, and I thanked the angels before I even phoned and said, thank you for sorting this out for me, right? Now she said, well, ordinarily we can't really cancel a payment. However, this is what I'm going to do. And so basically they cancelled it. I then got another quote and ended up saving £70. Don't ask me how. I haven't got any clue how. And then they put me on direct debit. So I saved myself £70. I'm on direct debit and I'm going to get a refund for that money come back. So now I'm only like £18 or £20 going out this month. And so, can you see? And so Lindsay watched it and I said, I told you. I said, you just say, thank you for helping me get over this little problem. Whereas that could have been turned into a small little like Greek tragedy for me, you know, and that's the way to do it. If you think, oh my God, I'm not going to get parking when I get this, say thank you for my parking space before you even get there. You're going to feel a bit of a woolly doing it initially. But my God, does it put you in a beautiful space where you know no matter what comes up, no matter how hard it is, you will get through it. Don't get me wrong. You know, we're going to have horrific things like losses, go through horrible divorces, break up with people, lose our jobs, lose our houses. I've done all that. I did all that. I lost everything. I was just dusting bags with my dogs. And I wish that I knew now what I knew then. But that's about the learning of the human experience down here. Because in that space of losing my house, losing my holiday home, losing my career, losing my book deal, now I still can't find one, my partner stealing thousands and thousands of money from me, losing a partner, losing my friends, losing my identity, losing my social life, losing my health. I lost absolutely everything straight away after a road accident. Best thing that ever happened to me. I see that now, but at the time, that took me out of my faith. That took me into the darkest, deepest place of misery you could possibly imagine. The anger of this girl hitting me. The anger of my friends turning their backs on me because I knew secrets about them. The anger of the partner I was with taking all my money and putting me in debt and having bailiffs on my door. The anger of losing my credit rating. The anger of losing my health. The self-pity, the hatred of myself because I couldn't wash my hair and couldn't put makeup on and had pyjamas on and was putting weight on. Oh my goodness, it was just a torrent of one black wave after another. If I had what I had now, I would look for the beauty in it. I look for the beauty now in every single day. The gift of this position I'm in now is I appreciate things that people take for granted. So yesterday, I appreciated the fact there was a gluten-free cafe. I appreciate the fact that I could hear birds singing. I appreciated and completely embraced the fact that I was with a beautiful friend in front of me. I embraced the fact and completely was grateful for the fact that there was a robin that stood there staring at us for ages, really weirdly. I was thankful for the fact that the weather was good. I was thankful that I got a photograph of a baby goat in Cheddar Gorge. I am thankful for everything, no matter how small it is. I'm thankful for everything. So for instance, now I could sit here and think, well, that's just great. I had a nice day out and now I've got rest today. Otherwise, I'm going to burn out because of this stupid thing. So I can't, and I could end up going black wave after black wave after black wave. However, I'm sitting here thinking the birds are singing. I can open the door so my little babies can go in and out. I've got the most wonderful, wonderful, sorry, I'm going to get emotional. I've got the most wonderful gift and knowledge that I'm now sharing with you. And I'm getting the most beautiful emails from people. Sorry. happy tears, telling me how much I've helped them and changed their lives just for me sitting in my bed doing these videos. And I'm thankful that I'm here to be able to have the learning and the healing I've had the last 6 years to be able to sit here and say from my heart that you can live like this. You can live in the most beautiful bubble. You can live in an environment where you will not allow people to influence your feelings, your emotions, and who you are as a person. No matter what happens in your life, they can't change or influence you. I have never been so full of love for myself, so much respect for myself, and I've never felt so serene and so comfortable in my own skin, i.e. talking to you about brushing my hair, no makeup on. I've never felt so sure that everything will always be all right, and no matter what happens, even if it's a negative experience, beauty will come from it. And even the other day, you know, I'm so passionate about my writing, because I don't only want to do these videos, I want to write, well, I have written it, the book, Heaven Calling, to help you get through the worst thing, loss. And I've just been offered another column. So I have now have four columns out of the blue. And it's all helping for me to educate you. And I found completely randomly a thing from Pinterest, and now I can show you through photos how to educate you and how to help you. Isn't that a beautiful thing to have? I appreciate the fact I've got a roof over my head. I appreciate all the beautiful things I have around me. I appreciate this beautiful fairy, this angel that was bought for me. I appreciate the fact that see that little box there, my little shabby chic tissue box? I got that, found that for like £2 in a shop that was closing down. I look at my Tinkerbell mug there, and I think of the fact that I got it from Florida when I was well enough to go to Florida and buy that there and have a beautiful holiday. And I look at that Tinkerbell up there, and that Tinkerbell up there, I can show you. Sorry, it's a bit of a mess there because I'm packing. I don't know if you can see it. Can you see my Tinkerbell up there? That Tinkerbell represents me being back in Essex. I'd just done an evening of mediumship, and I came home, and my friends from Devon jumped out of a bush and surprised me for my birthday. And one of the presents they got me was that Tinkerbell. And that reminds me of that beautiful moment. This is why I have hope stones as well. So, for instance, that calcite that man gave me yesterday, that will basically stay in my heart forever, that a stranger felt completely compelled to give me a stone that is completely relevant for my needs at the moment. I would show you it, but I'm actually charging at the moment in some water from the White Spring from Glastonbury. So it's just doing a little bit of charging at the moment. And amazingly, it was a full moon last night. It was certainly bright. And so I put it in the moon last night, and then I'm just putting it in some chalice well water. So this is what I'm trying to show you. The more thankful and the more grateful you are for the most stupidest, littlest things around you, the more your energy vibrates to a higher vibration, higher frequency, the more you can be inspired to have those thoughts that they can bring to you, whether it's the angel realms, your guardian angel, the celestial realms in any frequency, the spirit world. They can suddenly say, do that, and you do it, and you think, oh my God, look what's happened because I just did that, you know? So give it a go. It is hard to begin with, but I automatically do it now. It's like anything. It's like learning to drive. You've got to think about the clutch, think about gear change, but now you do it automatically. And I used to have to think about it, and sometimes I used to be quite reticent in doing it because I'm like, do you know what? Yeah, thanks for that. Thanks for this. You know, I remember I was standing on a doorstep with two dustbin bags, homeless, and I was staying on people's settees for 8 months, and I'm in this beautiful cottage, and now moving to my dream home, overlooking Brixham Harbour, near to all my friends and near to everywhere I need to be. And I ordered that. I sat there and said, I'm ready now to move back from healing from this space. I need to be around people, and I need to be independent, and I need to start trying to get myself out meeting people now. And so back in September I pictured that I wanted a view. I want you to be right next to the harbour, right next to the shops. I want you to be able to take my dogs literally on a beautiful walk. I want you to be near the beach. I want you to be able to try and do hydrotherapy for myself in a wetsuit and float in the water. So I thought, oh, I need to be definitely near the sea that I can get there on a mobility scooter or walk. I'd like to be around my friends because I've got some beautiful, beautiful friends in Devon, so that I've got my friend network and my friend support. And I want to be in a house that is got character. But the problem is the houses near the harbour, a lot of them are terraced. And I needed a downstairs bedroom. I needed a downstairs toilet. I needed the back door to be near my bed so that if I had a bad day, I could let the dogs out and not have to walk very far. I needed to have views to keep my serenity and something to concentrate on. And I really did need to be detached because I just wanted to hear nature. I wanted to be in my own environment and not have anything next door. And I got it. I'm on top of a clifftop. I've got views across the whole of Brixham and the beginning of the sea and the harbour. I can walk to the shops because there's a little tiny path that leads straight into the high street. I've got my downstairs bedroom. I've got my downstairs toilet. It's detached. It's got the most stunning views. It's a mixture between cottage garden and seaside garden, and it is the most absolutely perfect house I could possibly imagine. And that's because I knew I deserved it. I knew that I needed a space more out of need than want because of, you know, obviously my condition. And I got exactly what I asked for. So think about where you want to be. Think about who you want to be. Think about what you would like in your life and start playing the I deserve it game. Because if you work this and you start giving out nothing but love, kindness, work on self-love, work on vibrations of making things conducive to happiness and contentment, surround yourself with photographs, surround of people you love, surround yourself with things that create beautiful memories, and they will help you to raise that feeling of, I would really like this now. I really want to do that job. I really want to go on holiday because I feel like, and obviously describe why you need that holiday. Not because I want to get a suntan and have a few cocktails, because I actually need the break. I need to recalibrate. I need to relax myself and be in an environment where I can think of my way forward. You'll get it. You'll find it cheap. You'll get it discounted. Someone will phone you up and say, oh, my aunt's had a cancellation. Do you want to go to a villa? It will come. I'm telling you, it will come from nowhere and it will deliver. I could sit here and talk for hours on every single thing that I've sent a thought out for. Again, I sent a thought out for the columns. I've been out of the circuit for years and I said to them, I really need to get some sort of columns. I need to start getting myself out there because this book won't go anywhere and you've made me write it. So I really would like that, please. The following day was my first email offering the first column out of the blue. You know, it does work. If you don't get the answers or you don't get the abundance that you've asked for, there's a reason for it. It's either not for this time. You know, it's not the right time. And I honour that because I said to them, look, if I'm not supposed to move, I totally get it. And if I, you know, if nothing flows, then I know this isn't right. And I understand that. And I'll wait until I feel like I need to do it again. And so if things don't come, look at why. Perhaps there's a reason why, because they will plan it out perfectly. Because I was going through all of this. When am I going to sell? And they told me it was March, April, and that I'd be in before August. But then I thought, God, this is a nightmare, because originally I was involved in a chain. I thought, this just doesn't feel right. And then slap bang, I'm sitting here waiting. And I said to them, I don't know what's going on, but I really need to know because I need a way to focus forward. Could you just help me with that? And thank you. Following day, I get a chain-free sale and a chain-free offer accepted because it was right time, right place. Okay, so don't get impatient. Don't think, oh my God, it's not working. Send your thought out, send your intentions out, thank them, relax, let it go, let the universe do the rest. I really hope this has helped you. And I've got no clue what I'm going to do next, but now I'm going to go for inspiration. I'm still waiting to do that live demonstration of someone that's coming in. But for the time being, I really hope this has helped you. Please start working it. Because I'm telling you, it will gobsmack you how you will get the abundance back to you. Laws of attraction, whatever you give out from your energy, you will get back. So if you're giving out jealous, hate, anything, you know, that's negative, it will come back, and that's all you're going to get. Just change your thought process, change your intentions, change the way you are about you and what you deserve, and watch for the results. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this. Please share it with anybody that you think will help. And please keep your beautiful messages and emails coming, because it just makes me feel that I'm doing something really worthwhile and useful. Until the next time, please take care. May the angels bless your path with everything you possibly want. Bye now.